Hi everyone, I'm Alex from PixTeller, and today we'll make a long video explainer to show you what's new with the animation mode release. One of the most popular PixTeller actions after download is the Use button. By clicking on Use button, a copy of the starting pre-made design will be made, and you can customize it to create a new visual asset, even if it's a new image, video, or GIF. So let's click on the Use button for my just created image, and let's make a short video from it. We're back in the PixTeller editor, in the default design mode. First of all, let's make a recap to see what elements I have in the image. Beside the page background, we have the button text element, the group of the shapes that create the button, the big text element, the big shape that is behind, and a photo. You can easily rearrange the order, hide or lock any element from the layer menu located on the top menu. What I would like to do is to show you how I move the Creative is Madness text element on the front of all others' design elements. Once I do that, let's show you the most amazing thing about PixTeller. On the right top of the canvas area, you'll have the Switch to Animation Mode button. By pressing it, something really amazing will happen. The editor will metamorph. When I designed it, I was inspired by my teenage period when I was working a lot with Flash from Macromedia after acquired by Adobe. Many years for me, Flash was one of the most powerful software I used and was really awesome. Now let's show you some of the animation mode sections. The most important for any animation tool is the timeline. From the timeline, you can set the total video time length. You can set how long an animation for an element can be. You can create, move, and delete instances. For any instance, you can change the related element properties and filters between two instances that have different properties. A video motion will be created, and by doing this, just imagine that you can have thousands of possibilities to animate a single simple design. Also, from the timeline, you can reset the instances to their default state from the design mode. And you can set the motion acceleration between two instances. On the left side are the Properties and Filters panel for each element instance I have selected. I will show only the properties and elements that can be animated. Also on the top, we keep the functions like Rotate, Opacity, and Alignment that can be used to create an animation. From the timeline, you can even reset the entire timeline to default if you think that something really wrong has happened, like I just did while playing. Now prepare the timeline for a 2.9 seconds video length. To do that, I'll move each last instance for the background and all elements at the 2.9 seconds time. I must select the instance and move it to the right accordingly. The default time per page is 2 seconds, but you may change this at any moment like I am showing you right now. Moving forward, let's animate the background by adding 5 more instances for the video background timeline. To do that, you have 2 options. One is to select the frame and click on the Add Instance button. The second option is to select the frame and change the background color property by clicking on the background color from the left section panel and change the color to a new one. Once a new property is added to a frame, a new instance is created, as you see. Now I'll change the background color for the first instances I have created. Once I set a different background color for each background instance, I already have an animation. To check that, you can click on any frame between two instances, and you'll see that you have a different background color for each of the frames. Also, you can click the play button to see a low-quality version of the animation. Please note that for the background, you can create only background color video motions. As you already know, you cannot scale or move the video background color. What can we do next? We can do things that you could never imagine. So, let's make an instance for the image element in the middle of the timeline, at the 1.5 seconds. To do this, I will select the image frame at the 1.5 seconds and click the Add Instance button. Once the instance has been created, let's change the image properties, filters, or effects for it. I'll open the Image Filters and Effects panel, and I will change the blur value and also the saturation value. To have an idea about what I should expect, I can select any video frame and see what the result should be, or just click the Animation Preview Play button. Now I'll create two more instances for the big shape and for creativity is madness text. I will select the 1.5 seconds frame for each design element, and I will click on the Add Instance button. Keep in mind that you can easily move any instances through the element timeline in case you need a different time. For the new instance created for the big shape, I'll apply a 360-degree rotation and a 75% opacity. For the 1.5 seconds instance of my Creativity is Madness text element, I will open the Text Filters panel, and I will set up the Warp Filter power to 0. Now let's take a quick look to see what we made, and let's continue to some advanced things. Let's set the acceleration for the shape. The default acceleration between two instances is linear. In my example, for the shape animation between 0 seconds and 1.5 seconds instances, I will set an ease out acceleration. And for the shape animation between 1.5 second and the 3 seconds, I will set the ease in acceleration. To set or change the acceleration, you must select any frame between two instances and click on the acceleration type from the top right corner in the timeline section as you see in my example. Let's create 5 new instances for the group button. I will click on each 0.5 seconds frame, 1 second frame, 1.5 seconds frame, 2 seconds frame, and 2.5 seconds frame, and add for each of them a new instance. For the instance at the 0.5 seconds of the group, I will change the color. Now I'll copy the 0.5 seconds instance by pressing the copy button from the top left of the timeline section. I will select and replace the 1.5 seconds and 2.5 seconds instance with it. The copy paste instance action will help you a lot in the video making process. I think that is enough, so I'll rename the title to a more relevant one. And now it's time to save the animation in order to download it. You have two options located on the top right corner. One is the Save button, which will save your animation source code without render, so you'll not be able to download the video or GIF after the save. This option is great when your work is in progress, and you don't want to lose the steps you made until the save is executed. The second option is Render and Save button, and I'll press it now. The action will start to render and upload the animation, including the source code, on our servers, in order to be able to download or use it at any moment. The time it takes to render depends on many factors, like animation time and size, your computer power, and your internet upload speed. In most cases, for a small time length video, a few seconds, the render and save time is under 1 minute. Once the render and save has been done, you'll have to choose from two options: continue to edit your animation, or click the download button to be redirected on the preview page. From the preview animation, you can click on the download button and download it in MP4 video format or GIF format. What is really cool is that you can adjust the size by keeping the aspect ratio according to your needs. From the actions panel, you can copy or move the video on any of your folders, or you can update your privacy settings or delete it, just like a regular design. The full power of PixTeller is that I can use any pre-made image or animation design. By pressing the Use button, I can easily just replace some elements in design mode, go in animation mode, save, and render. I'm Alex from PixTeller, and I really hope you enjoyed my video explainer. If you have questions regarding what we made, don't hesitate to contact me or one of my team via live chat or contact form directly on PixTeller.com. Until next time, please join PixTeller.com and create your own images, GIFs and videos for your websites, banners, social media posts, mobile apps, business, and more. It's free!